55551, and I am back with a video game review, and today we'll be taking a look at Mighty Number 9. This is based off the Wii U version. It's also available for the Xbox One, PS4, and I believe it's also also released on the PC as well. Boy, does this one have a history though, and I'm pretty sure by now all of you have heard the drama surrounding Mighty Number 9. The delays. The fact that they probably went way over their head over a lot of pushing a lot of things, such as a movie, anime, possibly an amiibo, though, and so far the reviews of the game, though. Alright, so believe me, this game has earned a lot of controversies and reputation. But is it as bad as a lot of people say it is? Well, having spent the last couple of days with it, though, I am going to say this. It's not a, by all means, not a bad game. But it is somewhat of a disappointment to a certain degree, though, okay? So, we'll get started with the pros and the cons, though. We'll start first with the pros. And, really, there's only two pros I could think of for this game, though, okay? excuse me, though. The first one has to do with the fact that the gameplay, believe it or not, is challenging and fun. I will say, I grew up in the 80s, though. I mean, I grew up playing games, you know, like Super Mario Brothers, Mega Man as well. I mean, I played some Mega Man games before in the past, though. And I have to say, the game... Excuse me just one second. Okay, there we go. I have to say, the game does maintain a bit of that Mega Man feel to it. I don't think that's a bad thing, though. I mean, it's still, you know, the run and shoot, you know, very similar to how the Mega Man games are. One change they did make that I really like is the new dash system. So basically what you do is, instead of, you know, you simply just attack, shoot, and attack the enemy and that's it, this one, you do shoot them, but instead of just continue shooting them until they're destroyed, in this case, you shoot them and then you dash right through them. This comes in handy because when you dash through them, depending on what the enemy is though, you'll get a different color from them. Blue will, I think, increases your score though. Yellow will give you a temporary shield though, for a bit though. Red temporarily increases your firepower, and green speeds up your character, okay? And so, I mean, I do like the new idea of this whole dash thing though. And I do like the fact the game also maintains, you know, memorizing enemies' patterns to, you know, kind of timing your jump. And in that difficulty that the Mega Man games have for, may not be for everybody, but as someone who grew up playing these games, I really enjoyed it though, okay? And I will say the game is fun and challenging. And I think the gameplay certainly was there for this game though. I think it certainly was. And to me, as an old school gamer, someone who grew up playing these games, that's a good thing. I really think that's a good thing, though, alright? And finally, the other pro I could think of is that it definitely has a lot of content in it that will keep you busy. It certainly has replayability. Beyond the 12 stages, I mean, there is New Game Plus for those who want to raise the difficulty up a bit, though, and want to certainly give it a challenge, though. Challenge mode, you know, for those who want to test out their platforming skills. Boss rush mode to see how quickly you could defeat some of these bosses, though. there's also online co-op, which can be used either in like an online race battle in which you go head-to-head as you race through stages, though, or two-player online co-op challenge mode where your two characters, Beck and Call, those are the characters in the game, work together to complete these challenges, though. There's also, I think, some accomplishments, though. I think there's a leaderboard as well. So, overall, as far as content goes, it's not bad. I mean, it certainly isn't bad, and it will certainly keep you going for a while, though, all right? So from a gameplay and a content perspective, that's where I believe Mighty No. 9 does succeed, however, okay? So anyway, we're going to take a little break. When we come back, we'll take the break, though. I'll show you some gameplay footage. Bear in mind, this is based off the Wii U version, so I just wanted to point that out, though. So take a break. Hope you enjoyed the footage. And when we come back, we'll get to the cons. And there are certainly cons and some of the legitimate criticisms I've made to the game, and I certainly think it's there. So hope you guys enjoy the footage, and we will be right back. Alright folks, so I'm going to show off some footage of me playing Mighty No. 9. Bear in mind, this is the Wii U version, probably different in the PS4, Xbox One, or even Steam version, so let's give it a go. Go to the main game.
Choose your next target.
Configure controls and features. Adjust graphics quality and volume setting. Return. New tip.
Online interface. Loading times, so it could be a bit of a pain in the ass, though.
The VR training program I devised. Care to try it?
All right, quit your lollygagging. It's up to us to stop those rampaging bots.
See what I can do. Here are the different levels you can do, and the DLC that comes with the game. See if I can do a previous level.
Technologies is secure, but robots continue to rampage in the area.
You are all set, then?
Professor! territory, and quickly. Beck, you forge ahead and clear a secure path. I'll follow and monitor your progress. Yes, sir.
We got the red one, which increases our firepower a little bit. The yellow one here gives you a temporary shield. I have to say, from a gameplay perspective, it's not that bad. It really isn't. Green one right here. This increases your speed, though. Here's where the boss battles gets interesting, though. Once you, like, ward them down and they turn into kind of like purple, okay, right now, I want to charge right into it. So there we go. That was good.
good. Okay, so here's an example of one of the levels. One area that might turn some people off is the difficulty spike, mostly because of the difficulty and timing your jumps as well. Bit of a difficulty spike here in the game. Not bad, but might not be good for a lot of people, though. And then, of course, you got the loading time. Not great either. Should skip them. This is on the normal difficulty. Ouch.
Thank you. in it.
That's a bit of money number 9 for you. Hope you enjoyed the footage, and we'll get started with part. We'll get to part 2 of our review, the cons. Review of Mighty Number 9, game that has earned
so much backlash and controversy so far. All right. Hope you guys enjoy the footage, or at least the Wii U version of the game that I have, though. Okay. So, as I said before, I should have told you the pros. I did like the gameplay. I thought it was fun. I did like the content. However, as enjoyable as the game is, it cannot escape the flaws and the issues that are basically pointed out to the game. So, and unfortunately, I have about 4, though, really, okay? We'll first start with the first one, okay? And that is the graphics, okay? I'm sorry. Unfortunately, it's certainly not. I mean, yes, there are worser games that I've seen, but I mean, visually speaking, I'm just not impressed with it. I mean, it looks like an early PS2 game, which is a little bit insulting because there are PS2 games that I've seen that looked better. I mean, Dark Cloud, which came out in 2001, won for the PS2, and that looked great. I mean, Rogue Galaxy, Devil May Cry, a personal favorite of mine, along with Devil May Cry 3, though, God of War 1 and 2, both personal favorites of mine. I mean, it looks like, or hell, even Maximo Armia Zin and Maximo Ghost of Glory, a game that was in development since the Nintendo 64 day, even I think Maximo Ghost of Glory looks better than what Mighty No. 9 looks like, and it's just, I'm sorry, it's just, visually speaking, it's not that impressive, okay, especially, you know, some of the, especially one of the levels with the fire, it just looks, it just doesn't look that impressive. I'm sorry. I mean, okay, so now that I got the graphics part out, we'll go into the next one, which is the frame rate issue. And unfortunately, it is there, even with the Wii U version, though, okay? I will say the frame rate is not as terrible as some people said. I'm still able to play the game and all that. I mean, it's not as bad as, say, I'm just going to throw a game out there, Assassin's Creed Unity was, or Alien Colonial Marines wasn't anyway, which, I mean, that's not saying much, really, though, but it's still not good. I just felt the game was just having a hard time trying to keep up, and though, and it, and while it certainly isn't unplayable, it's certainly not unplayable, but it just doesn't look, it just doesn't, the frame rate is not good. It just feels like it's, like, I mean, it's not even run. I just feel like it's not even maybe close to 30, but I'm not 100% sure, though. But either way, frame rate wise, again, not as bad as Assassin's Creed Unity. It certainly isn't unplayable, but it's certainly not good, okay? The next one, and I will like to state, this one is for the Wii U version only, okay? So this one doesn't apply to the PS4 or Xbox One or PC version. This particular part is for just the Wii U, and that is the fact the game really doesn't use anything with the gamepad. So the only thing the game uses, at least the Wii U version of Mighty No. 9 does use, is the fact that it only uses off-TV play. That's it. No special feature with the gamepad or anything. Good or bad, that's going to be your opinion on that one, though. But anyone expecting the game to use anything else? No. It's only for off-TV play. I mean, it's the same thing with Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze when that came out in 2014. Only thing the gamepad was used was just for off-TV play. That's it. Didn't use it for anything else. So, if you were going in hoping this game to use the gamepad for something, sorry. Doesn't do that, though. Doesn't do that. It's just off-TV play mode only. So, unless you're big on off-TV play mode, you probably best just play it on with the Pro Controller, though. Okay. And finally, last but not least, and this is, I don't have an issue with this, others may do, and that is the difficulty spike, okay? Now, as I said earlier on with the pros, though, as someone who grew up in the, you know, grew up with the NES and so on, I've played these games before, so the difficulty spike for me is not as bad or as big of an issue. For me, though, I mean, I'm aware the game can be a bit frustrating for some people, but for me, though, not as big of an issue. Yes, it can be a bit difficult, though. Some of it is timing your jumps and so on, and learning the controls very well, and enemies' patterns and so on. So, for me, it isn't. That said, If you've never played a Mega Man game before or have never played these type of games before, though, that's going to be the issue for you, though, because this, because of difficulty spike, you will be dying a lot in the game. Believe me, you certainly will be dying a lot, and that might be difficult for some people, though, all right? However, there is a bright spot I will say is that you can go to the option menu and change the lives. Instead of having starting with 2, you can start with 9. So it does give you, it does help though, okay? Doesn't change much, but it won't change a whole lot, but it will certainly help to a certain degree, okay? Overall, at the end though, Mighty Number 9 is certainly not a bad game, but it's not a great game either, okay? I mean, the gameplay is certainly fun, and there is a good amount of content in it, but the visuals, the frame rate, the difficulty spike, combined with the reputation this game earned from, you know, multiple delays, though, the game not looking as good as the concept art that has came out for it, though, the Red Ash debacle, in which they launched on the Kickstarter for another game, which people are not going to pour money on because they haven't played their first game, haven't played, you know, Mighty Number 9 or everything, and when that seemed to fail, from what I understand, a Chinese publisher picked it up, people accused the developers of this, and when they tried to restart the Kickstarter, people were not even putting money in that one. The idea that they, pushed for, you know, a movie, the anime, toy lines, and amiibos, and of course, not focusing on the game, though, and finally, last but not least, I think we all know the infamous one and only god-awful trailer, you know, the one that says you'll be an anime fan on prom night. I'm pretty sure it's probably going to be a meme somewhere down the road. I mean, combine all that and the reputation, I feel that not only would hurt the developers to a certain degree, I can't see them doing another Kickstarter because they've lost that reputation though, right? Now they've lost it at this point. I mean, I could be wrong, but I can't see them doing another one though. But I also believe I think there is a good chance this could kill off any series though. I mean, that's a shame because there's so much potential this series could have had. I would have loved to see more of Mighty. I like the idea behind Mighty Number 9, but the reputation that carries it now, I think, just damaged it. And I think that's really unfortunate. To me, it feels like the developers went way over their heads with this. I think they should have focused on the game first before doing anything else, though. I think that's what they should have done in the first place. Okay, before I end this video, I will say that I just came back from the movies and I just saw Independence Day Resurgence, though, okay? The one that's been getting some negative reviews by critics and some people making a big deal about it. All right. I will say this. I was 14 when the original one came out back in 1996. I remember seeing that multiple times. I remember how big of a deal that movie was. And till this day, it still remains a personal favorite of mine, okay? Having come back from the movie, I will say this. While I do not see this topping the original 1996 version, I just cannot see that happening, though. I still think it was good. It was what I expected. It was a good popcorn flick, and it's certainly something. It's definitely worth entertaining, though. I mean, it was nice to see Bill Pullman, Jeff Goldblum return and reprise their roles and everything. Though, it is a little disappointing that Will Smith is not in this movie, unfortunately, but again, I'm not losing sleep over it, though. It still maintains some of its humor. Data, you know, from Star Trek The Next Generation, he's back as well. And he was also providing some humor to it. Love, you know, the fights, you know, the pilot fights. And, of course, the Alien Queen. That was awesome as well, though. I do hope this movie does well enough that we do get a part 3. I would love to see a part 3, though, okay? Hopefully, if part 3 does happen, hopefully I don't have to wait another 20 years for it, though, okay? If that were to happen, I would be 54 by then, okay? I really hope we don't have to wait another 20 years. So I hopefully another sequel will happen, though, at some point down the road. I really hope the movie does well enough that we can do another, see another sequel, though, okay? As far as the reviews go, personally, while I won't say film critics are wrong all the time, I do have to say I just feel sometimes that they review this movie thinking that it's going to be Oscar-worthy and everything else. And not every movie's like that. This is just popcorn flick, dumb fun. And that's fine. That's what I went in to go see. I went in expecting it to be what I thought it was going to be based on the trailer. And I came away happy about it. I do accept this as a sequel, though. I really do. I will accept this as a sequel. I will, as I said before, I don't think as good as the original 1996 one. But I still enjoyed it nevertheless, though. I really do, okay? Anyway, this concludes my review of Mighty No. 9 for the Wii U and my thoughts on Independence Day Resurgence, okay? And again, these are my opinions. But what are yours? Has the negative reviews and the backlash turned you away from picking up Mighty No. 9? Or are you willing to dive in and give it a chance and see for yourself if it's as bad as people claim it is? Do you have any issues with the games, like the graphics, the frame rate, or the difficulty spike, or that's not a big deal for you? If you are planning to pick up the game, are you getting the Wii U version like I got, or are you planning to get it for, you know, PC or Xbox One or PS4, or are you waiting to see if they bring it to the 3DS and Vita? I think they're working on it, but who knows what's going to happen. After the negative reviews have come out, we'll see if it even comes to those two, okay? And of course, Independence Day Resurgence. Again, did you plan to see it, though? Did the reviews turn you off? Or did you figure, say, screw the movie critics, I'm going to see it anyway, though? Do you think it was still good? Do you think it's as good as the 1996, the original 1996 one? Do you think it's better? Or do you think, or you're like me, it's like, it's good, but we'll never top the original one, though, okay? As always, sound off on the comments below, in the comment section, though. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would appreciate that, though. And feel free to share this video if you want to, okay? So, don't mind. The more viewers, the more subscribers, the better, okay? Anyway, this concludes my video review of Mighty No. 9. And my thoughts of Independence Day Resurgence, though, okay? It's evening in Southern California. I'll be sort of getting myself ready because, of course, I have work tomorrow, though, as always. So I will see you again next time when I do another video review or another video, whenever that be. So hopefully that will be soon. But otherwise, as always, from evening from Southern California, Orange County to be exactly, SoCal, though, I will see you again next time, all right? And you guys out there on YouTube, have a good evening, though. Bye!